Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, singing a new song. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he had done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm had gotten him victory. The Lord had made known his salvation, his righteousness as he openly shone in the sight of the heathen. He had remembered his mercy and his truth towards the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the earth. Make a loud noise, and rejoice and sing praise before the Lord. For he cometh to judge the earth. With righteousness shall he judge the world, and the people with equity. Psalm 98, 1 through 9. New occasions of triumph require a new song to be sung. It would not have been the fullest of praise for Miriam to conduct the music of the daughters of Egypt. An old song could not have spoken out the feeling of that generation. They have to have a new song. Sing unto the Lord, for he had triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider had he thrown into the sea. When Deborah and Barak had taken care of the host of Sisera, they did not borrow Miriam's song. They had a new song for that new event. They said, "Awake, awake, Deborah, awake, awake, utter a song. Arise, Barak, and lead thy captivity captive, thou son of Binoam." We find this desire to sing a new song unto the Lord recorded in the scripture. This is how it was at the building of the temple and the solemn feast days. Poets would declare, "O come, let us sing unto the Lord a new song." What will it be like when the 24 elders and the 4 living creatures shall fall before God upon their faces and worship him forever and ever? We need to anticipate what is soon to come and gear for it now while we can. Now is the time to prepare for this day. I want us to focus on the last song. It is a song that has never yet been sung. It is going to be a song of supreme victory. All the principalities and the powers of this world will be laid low. The pride of the earth will burst like a bubble. The things seen in the natural will fold up. The victory of Jesus Christ will be supreme in all the earth. It will be time to sing a new song. No event in all history will even compare to it. It stands matchless and without rival. It's hard sometimes to see as it's yet in the future. So we must constantly remind our quick-to-forget minds that the supreme victory is coming. We must remember there will not be anybody to dispute the claim of God. Some battles are hard to discern who was the victor. Back in history, when we look at the Vietnam War, we have to ask the question, who won the war? As a matter of fact, was there any winner at all? When it comes to the Lord's final battle, there will be no question who will win. The dragon's head will be completely crushed, that he will do nothing but bite his iron shackles and growl out his confession that God is stronger. Satan's evil empire will come crashing down so hard that there will be deep groans of dismay and shrieks of terror from the bottomless pit of hell. When we read about wars in history, sometimes we see occasions where it looks like a certain side will win, but things shift and the side you never thought would win turned out to be victorious. Beloved, when we read in the light of heaven that God never had questionable days in battle and that he was never on the verge of losing. In a normal war, the soldiers have to always be ready for the next possible battle. The scattered enemy troops may rally. Those who fled may come back together, and the soldiers must be quick to battle again. Not so in God's final battle, where we sing a new song. The final blows are forever crushing, total, final. That is why we will sing a new song, because we will begin a new life in glory with him forever. The thought of the day: God never had questionable days in battle, and he was never on the verge of losing. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.